This tutorial is part of our Django Database ORM Mastery course, where we learn how to master building and interacting with databases within a Django project. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other course resources from our Udemy course. Alternatively, you can access the course YouTube playlist featuring tutorials from this course. Links to our Udemy course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. This tutorial is not intended to dive deeply into the subject matter. We hope to introduce and take the first steps, priming you with underpinning knowledge. In this tutorial, we identify the role of the Django Model Manager. A model manager is challenging to describe from a technical standpoint, especially if you are unfamiliar with Python object-oriented programming concepts. I take the approach of exploring the model manager from a developer perspective, developing interactions with the database. In order to build a database interaction, we first need to build a database. The first step when building an application we learned in the previous tutorial is to design a database, a set of tables and relationships. Once we have designed our database, we create Django models. Models are implemented by creating a new class. Within our model, we define fields and behaviors. Once we've developed our Django model, this information is used to then actually build the tables within our database backend. So it's important to remember that models represent tables in our database. So let's imagine we have now built a set of Django models. What next? We have a set of tables, so now we need to perform operations and queries on our database. Typical tasks include creating, returning, updating, and deleting data from our database, commonly known as CRUD operations. Now let's remember that Django provides a non-SQL approach, a way to present the Django ORM instructions to interact with the project database, tables, and data in our primary programming language, Python. Using the Django ORM to perform some operations on the database would not be possible without the model manager. So let's think of the model manager first as a doorway, or more technically, an interface into the Django ORM's inner features and functionality. The model manager as an interface provides access to the ORM query tools, the query set API, a topic which we will explore in the following tutorial, and database communication. So here's a basic visualization of the idea. On the left-hand side, we have the Django model. We need to utilize the model information and interface with the ORM toolkit, the query set API, for example, through the model manager. The query set API, as we will learn, provides the toolkit for us to then build a query which can then be executed on the database. So every time that we build a query within our Django application, we're going to need to utilize or pass through or interface through the model manager to access the query set API tools. So if we take a look at that in action, let's first remind ourselves of a typical SQL statement. Here we have a select statement. We select the star, so star refers to all fields and rows from the student table. So we're selecting all the data from the student table. So this is a typical SQL query. So if we take a look at the Django equivalent, here we construct a query set via the manager on the model, or on your model class, to retrieve objects from the database. Here we can identify the individual components of this. So here we have the model, reference to the model. Here we have the manager. Now the default manager for every model is called objects. So we have student, the model, manager, objects, and then we have some of the tools from the query set API, in this case, the all method. So like I just mentioned, to ensure that every model has access to the query set API, every model is assigned a default model manager, called objects. In more advanced cases, it's actually possible for us to customize this model. We can change the name, for example. We can add extra methods or modify data returned from the database. Okay, so in this tutorial, we explored the role of the model manager. We learned that the model manager is a doorway, or more technically, an interface that provides access to Django ORM features. Notably, the Django model manager provides access to the query set API. As a Django developer, we need to use the query set API to query the database, and return data from the database, for example. All Django models can have one or more model managers. Each model will have a model manager assigned by default called objects. We can add multiple model managers. Model managers can be extended to provide customizations, which might, for example, modify data returned from the database.